contest. This time it is UK versus Germany. And firstly, to enter inside the ring, fighting out the red corner, representing the UK, please welcome Paul Jenkins.
Yes, we've got Paul Jenkins here and Peter Angra. Paul Jenkins, everyone in the UK has seen knows Paul. He's the most prolific fighter with a 26, 21 and 4 record.
Well, he fights every other weekend, I think.
Yeah.
And I think somewhere in between fighting he has to go to work.
I don't think he actually does work. I think this is what he does for a job.
I think he works at a dormant, so it's pretty similar.
Peter Angra, actually a well-known German fighter. On the circuit.
He is they're both good, decent stand-up fighters. Paul recently came up to Quantum Gym, sparring with some of our guys. Did some good round sparring with big Andy Butlin, one of the pro boxers up at Quantum. And he is very, very good. Very strong punches and a good kicker. So it'd be difficult to dominate on the stand-up, I'd imagine. He beat Paul Daly just recently in a K-1 fight. Paul Daly, we'll see later on, fighting for a title, I believe.
Well, I think Peter may be actually pulling up the wrong game plan. He looks very sharp on the feet. But a problem with Paul Jenkins can often be that he's very slow to warm up. But if you're going to rush him like this,
yeah,
you're going to wake up the beast, I suppose.
That's it. And the beast, if you wake it up, is pretty deadly. I believe Paul's girlfriend Barbara is in the crowd tonight. So she'll be showing some support there from Wales. Oh, great takedown from Paul.
Beautiful trip.
Holding side control now.
Cleared the guard on the way down.
And this is, you'll see Paul, I know we were saying that Paul's a very good stand-up fighter, but he's also a blue belt in Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu and has won Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu competitions. And he's a very strong ground and pound. You don't really see him pull off many submissions, but he does use very good positioning and ground and pound.
Well, as we mentioned...
And there again, spoke too soon as Paul slickly moves to take the back and could have a submission here.
Choke. Well, as we mentioned earlier, it's foolish to think these fighters aren't well-rounded.
Yeah, that's it. Paul, I remember he fought down in Wales at the start of last year and pulled off a great suplex. And again, you wouldn't even think of Paul as a wrestler, but it just shows these guys have got every single part of the game.
That's it. He pulled off a beautiful takedown just now, pass guard on the way down, indicating how takedowns for MMA is different to takedowns for wrestling.
That's for sure. And there's some solid punches.
Here's where they call him, that's what they call him, the hand stone.
And he got the submission. He didn't have the submission quite on. He had it across the face, so he's keeping a position. He's working in some shots. Peter Angra might be shaking his head, but I don't think he'll be doing it for very long if these carry on.
No, but he's defending the choke very well. Although that looks like it might be the least of his worries, because Paul does hit very hard.
That's what I'm saying. They don't call him hands of stone for nothing.
I think that could have been a mistake. I think in MMA, if you've got someone's back, you should probably try and sink the choke rather than switch for the armbar, because if you lose it, you lose your position. In submission, it's not as dangerous.
Look for Paul to stand up now. Peter Angra is going to try and work some shots by the looks of things from stand up, but I think he's going to try and pass guard. It looked like he tried to kick him in the head then.
Yeah, and he did stamp on him earlier. The axe kick almost becoming a stamp.
That going for the ankle lock by Peter Angra could have been a mistake there.
Well, Paul seems to have secured his own.
Yeah, Paul looks to have the more dominant position there.
But Paul's going for an Achilles tendon stretch, which, although very, very painful, may not cause as much damage as a heel hook
that Peter Angra is looking for.
Sometimes, if a Achilles tendon stretch isn't on properly, you can tough it out. But like as Peter did there. But if you get caught in a heel hook, yeah, as we said, the heel hook is a very dangerous ankle lock.
Yeah, and it can pop the knee very badly. Paul Jenkins had very good sportsmanship showed. The referee didn't see the tap, but he said, yeah, I did, I tapped. He knows when he's got caught by
I think I heard a pop as well. Paul may be icing the ankle later on. Right now, full of adrenaline, but I think he may be icing the ankle tonight.
Yeah, that could hurt. But Paul did look, some marking there on the leg of Paul Jenkins. I don't know if that's to do with the submission. But Paul was there dominating the fight, and it just shows you the submission can change everything over completely.
Yeah, he seems to be limping on his left leg slightly as well. But that could be from the kick.
A good win for Peter Angra and another solid performance from Paul Jenkins.
Yeah, that was a very slick submission. He hit the top position, Luke looking to strike, and suddenly, whoop, he was on the ankle.
And that's the beauty of mixed martial arts, can change jobs. On here with Jeremy Bad Boy Bailey, UK MMA superstar, giving out the trophy.
Well, especially from this area, the Basingstoke Bad Boy. He'll be a very well-known character here.
Yeah.
Interesting fact, inside the ring and in front of the camera, Jeremy comes across very brash and arrogant. Away from the camera, he's actually a very, very nice person.
Yeah, I mean, I've spoken to him behind the scenes and he is a very, very nice person. So there we go, Peter Angra, the winner in a very good match.
Man, this way, that's it. Buddy, this way. That's it.